he said about company IMC. So we choose Petronas Gas Berhad as our company.
My name is Wan Rosabina. I will explain about assets, liabilities and equities of Petronas Gas Berhad. This is the 5-year group financial information. Next, I will explain about assets. From non-current assets, for 2014 until 2017, it shows increasing value. But on 2018, it shows decreasing value. But for current assets, it shows increasing value. And for the total asset, it shows uptrend. So there are fixed assets and current assets. In fixed assets, there are property, plant and equipment and depreciation and also investments. And current assets, it shows cash and cash equivalents and also inventories. For non-current liabilities, it shows increasing value from 2014-2018. And for current liabilities, it shows increasing value from 2014-2017, but shows decreasing value from 2018. But for total liabilities, it shows uptrend value. Okay, so for the equity, there are share capital first, and also reserves secondly. There are retained profits, capital revenue, foreign currency, translation reserve, and also hedging reserve. And for the third one, there are non-controlling interest. Okay, that's all for assets, liabilities, and equities.
Assalamualaikum, I am Farhan Pratika. Today I'm going to show you the income statement over 5 years of Petronas Gas Berhad. Okay, from this statement, we know that this company was rise in their revenue year by year. This is because the production was increased and the revenue also increasing too. Over 5 years of this company was shown improvement.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Aziz Leka Binti Anjalaza. Okay, I will explain is about sale. Okay, based on the figure, the sale show that the uptrend movement, which is the lowest is years 2014 and the highest is 2018. Okay, for expenses, operating expenses and cost of goods sold, it showed the uptrend movement from the 2014 until 2018. This is because this company is a leading of the transportation gas in the Malaysia. Okay, next is market ratio. Current ratio, current ratio and net capital, net working capital show the downtrend movement, which is from the 2014 until 2018. It shows that Petronas Gas Berhad is able to meet short-term obligation. Okay, for profit, based on the gross profit, earning before interest and tax, and earning after tax. For first 3 years, which 2014 until 2016, show that the downtrend movement. However, for the 2017 and 2018, show the upturn movement.
So, next I will explain about activity ratio. This is ITO for PGB. Based on the figure, ITO has unstable trend, which from 2014 until 2016, it shows that downtrend. While starting from 2016 until 2018, it shows uptrend. However, in 2018, it showed that this company is able to use inventory to generate sales compared to 2017. Next, this is average collection period, ACP of PGB. As you can see, from 2014 until 2016, the company was increasing to 52 days in 2015. 58 days in 2016. After that, in 2018, the company only take 41 days to collect account receivable from the agencies. The company was taken less time compared to 2017 to collect account receivable. Next is about fixed asset turnover. It shows that the trend had a downtrend from 2014 until 2016. And it started to uptrend since 2016 until 2018. This company shows that they are able to utilize fixed asset to generate sales. And for the last, for equity ratio is total assets turnover. The highest total asset is 2014, which is 0.33 times, and the lowest is 2016 and 2017, with 0.28 times. The company is able to utilize its total asset to generate sales, but in 2014 is better than 2018 to generate sales.
Assalamualaikum, I am Farah Farah Kavidya Othman. Today I am going to show you the income statement over 5 years of Petronas Gas Berhad. Okay, from this statement, we can know that this company was raised in their revenue year by year. This is because the production is increased and the sales is increasing too. Over 5 years, this company has shown their improvement. However, the profit after tax show uptrend and downtrend movement. In 2014 to 2015, it represent to rise movement, but in 2016, the graph is sloping down aggressively. Thus, in 2017 and 2018, the chart starts to move upward again. So this is the gap ratio. Okay, as you can see in 2018, it indicates as the highest debt ratio, with 18.06%, while in 2014 it indicates as the lowest debt ratio with 5.04%. Therefore, Petronas Berhad is not good in managing its debt. Okay, for the debt equity was rising up high from 2014 until 2018, which from 0.01 times until 0.25 times. Thus, it proved that Petronas Berhad position is less risky. For the time interest rate, in 2014, the company had to meet its interest payment for 28.06 times, which indicates as the highest. While for year 2015, 2016, 2017 and 2018, it shows a decreasing amount compared to 2014. Thus, it proved that the company is not able to meet its interest payment. Okay, for the gross profit margin, as you can see in 2014, it indicates as the highest data, while in 2017 until 2018, it indicates it increasing. So therefore, Petronas is able to control the cost of goods sold. For the operating profit margin, in 2014 it indicated as the highest data, while for 2017 until 2018 it decreasing. It shows that this company has low productivity and have no ability to control all costs except interest and taxes in corporation. For the return of total assets, it shows a decreasing amount from 2014 until 2017. However, in 2018, it suddenly goes up. It means that they are able to generate more return.
Hello, my name is Nurul Kamila, and today we want to talk about technical analysis of Petronas Berhad. So, let's start with comparative between KLCI and Petronas Berhad. Here we can see the purple line is KLCI and the Japanese candlestick is Petronas Berhad, and we can see from December 2018 to January to February 2019, it's underperforming the KLCI, and the rest is outperforming until December of 2019. And here move on to trend analysis, where we can see the major trend of Petronas Berhad is bearish, and between the major trend is there is an intermediate trend showing a bullish trend. And next we move on to patterns, where we can see there is a triangle and a support resistance. And next, so let's move on to indicators, where we use 6 indicators to determine buying and selling signals, where here we can see we use MACD, SMA, which double and single, and RSI. So there is crossover happens of SMA and MACD, with showing a buying signal, and RSI is showing the line is above 30% where it is a buying signal, and there is a selling signal where the RSI is above 70%, and the MACD and SME is doing a crossover. So next is indicators of William, percentage R and stochastics. So the selling signal here, we can see that MACD and, William and stochastic is doing a crossover, and there is a selling buying signal of stochastic and William doing a crossover. So we can conclude here that Petronas Berhad is expected to bullish in a very short time, and investors are advised to hold to buy. That's all.